But for now, we have our five possible options coded in here, so that's perfect, so click OK. Now next, say someone checks this box here, Other, they get a 5 for ethnicity, but then they state something like biracial. So whenever we have a box or an entry that people can type something in, that needs its own variable. So here in row 3, we're going to enter Other ethnicity. Okay, and then we don't want it to be numeric. That means it's going to be a number. And it's not. It's going to be text here. So go ahead and click on numeric. Click on the three dots. And then select string. And string indicates that you can have text. And then let's change our characters to 25. That will allow 25 spaces. And then we're done there. So string is entered. Okay, our next is age. And then notice for age, they're going to enter their age, and we ask for it in years. So they'll enter 22, 43, or what have you. So we don't actually have to make codes like 1 for male, 2 for female, and so on. That value is going to be entered directly. So here, all we have to do is create the variable age, and then press enter. And then next, we have 5 questions from what's called the satisfaction with life scale. And here people read the statements and says that below are 5 statements you may agree or disagree with using a 1 to 7 scale where SD is strongly disagree and SA is strongly agree. Answer each of the following as they apply to yourself. So the first statement on the scale is, in most ways, my life is close to my ideal. And then a person will circle one of these values, indicating whether they tend to agree with the statement or tend to disagree with it. If someone very much agreed with the statement, then they'd circle 7, saying they strongly agreed. If they agreed somewhat, they'd probably circle 5, or maybe 6, and so on. Now notice we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 questions on the scale. And this is a real scale by Diener, Satisfaction with Life Scale. It's a very popular scale. And what I'm going to do in SPSS is, notice a person will answer one of these 7 choices here. They'll give one of these answers. They'll circle a 4 or 6 or what have you. So anytime someone answers a value, it needs to have a variable. So I need to create a variable in SPSS for this question or statement, a variable for this statement, and so on. And I'm going to call it the Satisfaction with Life Scale, or SWLS for short, 1 for the first question on it. This will be SWLS2, and so on. So let's go ahead and create those. So I have SWLS1, and I'll just press enter. SWLS2, these don't have to be in caps, but I'm just doing that. SWLS4, and then SWLS5. Now, we could go ahead for our own notes and code what these values mean if we want to. 1 is strongly disagree, 7 is strongly agree, and so on. And I'll go ahead and do that. I'll just code the extremes. So here a value of 1 is strongly agree. Let's make sure that's right. Nope, a value of 1 is strongly disagree. So it's important to double check that to make sure we get it right. And then a value of 7 is strongly agree, as is shown here. So let's make sure that checks out. 1 is strongly disagree, 7 is strongly agree. So that looks good. Click OK. And then something that's nice here, I can just copy this and then select these and select paste, and it will paste all of those value labels to the remaining questions. So that saves us a lot of time. And that's only something we want to do when the variables share the same structure. So in other words, SWLS has 1 is strongly disagree, 7 is strongly agree. Well, so does the rest of these, so we can go ahead and copy those. Okay, so that looks good. We can go to the Data View tab now, and here are our variables. Gender, ethnicity, the other ethnicity, that once again is if someone has an answer like biracial, age, and then the 5 items on the satisfaction with life scale. So let's go ahead and take an example and enter some data.